welcome. The report you are writing will not just be based on your own work. You will be building on the work of others, using their results, their models, and their methods. In this video, we will discuss how to mention your sources correctly. References or citations are given for several reasons. First of all, you need to give credit where credit is due. When using a result, model, formula, or figure created by someone else, you should not pass it off as your own. To avoid confusion, you should state explicitly whose work it is. In reverse, correct use of references also serves to highlight your own contributions to the problem you are working on. The reader should know which tools and materials were provided by others, and then see what you made with them. Additionally, providing your readers with references allows them to check out the sources of the results and data you used. This way, they can independently verify your work and build on it. Providing appropriate references makes your work more convincing. Finally, references can be used by your readers to find further information on the subject, such as background information or related results. Now that we have discussed the why of references, let us discuss what should be referenced. First of all, we reference ideas. An idea can be a formula, a theorem, a model, a scientific result, and so on. Whenever you use someone else's idea, give credit to them. Secondly, of course, you could use someone else's data, or a picture, a figure, a graph. Whenever you are in doubt, it's best to give a reference. However, some information may be regarded as common knowledge. How to solve the differential equation y equals 4y prime is one example of common knowledge among mathematicians. Euler's method is another such example, and its name will automatically give credit to its inventor. In general, if you learned it in this course, you do not need to give a reference. The information in this video can also be regarded as common knowledge. For further reading on citations and references, we recommend the following websites. Now that you know why and when to use references, the unit below will discuss how to include these references in your text. Thank you very much and good luck.